I had some trepidation about coming to England. I wasn't sure if the people here knew The Wizard of Oz well enough, the movie, and whether they would get the show, you know. We had done so well in the States, but of course The Wizard of Oz is like our national myth. So I really was not sure how well it would translate here. And this was our first go, you know, outside of America. And then, of course, turned out everybody knew The Wizard of Oz, and we got, you know, such wonderful response here. And here we are 15 years later. It's amazing.
I mean, 15 years, gosh, because I saw Wicked when it was in previews back 15 years ago. So to actually be sitting here being interviewed as the person that's playing Elphaba feels crazy and really super special and exciting.
Wicked, the musical, is based on a novel by Gregory Maguire. And I happened to be on holiday with some friends, and one of my friends, making idle conversation, said, "Oh, I'm reading this really interesting book. It's called Wicked, and it's kind of the Oz story from the Wicked Witch's point of view." And oh, it's happened again. All the hairs in my arms stood up, and I thought, that's just the most wonderful idea that I've ever heard, and it's so right for me in so many ways in terms of the themes I like to deal with and the kind of stories I like to tell. So I immediately began to investigate if the rights could be available to turn it into a musical.
My first memory is listening to Defying Gravity. I don't know how I came across it. I feel someone in school was like, "Have you heard this new musical called Wicked? You should listen to it." And I went home and listened to Defying Gravity on repeat, I think. And I think I was about 13, 14 then. And then it came to my 15th birthday and I came to watch it with my family and was just absolutely blown away. Just completely taken to the land of Oz, and I've never looked back really. I'm still obsessed.
If you'd have told me at 13, 14 that one day I would be singing Defying Gravity every day, I'm like, are you crazy? Like, it's because you put you, it, there comes with that a pressure, because people expect it to be done in a certain way, and you know, you want to do it well. So you kind of put pressure on yourself to be the best that you can be, which can be quite tiring. Yeah. But just getting out there, and you can feel the electricity kind of when you're about to fly, essentially, and sing the end of the song. Everyone's there with you, you know, kind of going on that journey with you. And like, you know, I sometimes look down and the ensemble have run on and Soph's down there, and it just, it's like, oh, this is just incredible. It's such an incredible feeling.
Well, I think I'm on show 652. So I, as much as I haven't been here for 15 years, that is for me quite a long, a lot of shows. I think to date, my fondest memory will be the reopening, the 15th of September, because of the weight that I felt was lifted off us all as a cast, as I could feel it with the audience that could have been their first experience back in the theatre. It meant so much more than your own first night or your last night, because that's very specific to you, or maybe the cast you're with at the time. But this felt like it was everybody. It felt like the world was there, and like something changed in that moment. So for me, that will always stick with me.
So for months, we had been anticipating that the first line of the show of Wicked happens to be Glinda saying, "It's good to see me, isn't it?" And of course that line was written without knowing that there was going to be a pandemic and that we were going to be gone for a year and a half. But we all have expected what's going to happen when she says that line. And but then to be in the theater a couple of weeks ago on Broadway, when the actress Jenna Clare, who plays Glinda now, came down in her bubble and said, "It's good to see me, isn't it?" And everybody screamed and cheered, and I cried, and I'm crying again. Yeah, that was just like, I'll remember that for the rest of my life.
It's amazing, but it's because of those people that we are still here and we're still going, and word gets out about Wicked, people bring their friends, you know. So thank you for being here with us and for supporting us. We couldn't do it without you.